Hello students, welcome back to online class. Today I am going to teach you English subject for the class 5th. Students, in this lecture we are going to see the new lesson. The name of lesson is Major Dhyan Chand. Okay student, on your English Bal Bharati textbook page number 16, lesson number 7, the name of lesson is Major Dhyan Chand. Okay students, if we have read this name of the lesson, that is Major Dhyan Chand, it is a name of a person. Okay students, did you understand? If you have seen the picture on your textbook, look at here. Here is a given some picture. Here is a given the picture of Major Dhyan Chand. What you understand that if you have seen the picture, then here is in this picture some players playing the games, and which game they playing? They playing the game of hockey. Okay students, first of all tell me, do you know how many players is needed for the game hockey? How many players? 11 players. Okay students, you should keep in mind, 11 players is needed for playing the game hockey. So what is the Major Dhyan Chand? Dhyan Chand is a name of was a name of person. Okay student, Major Dhyan Chand was a name of person, and the person who was a hockey player. Okay student, so did you remember in the third standard we have learned like this, similar like this lesson, that is Khashaba Jadhav. The name of lesson is Khashaba Jadhav. We have, who was Khashaba Jadhav? Do you know Khashaba Jadhav was a wrestler, and he won the bronze medal in the Olympic Games. Like that way we have seen the lesson, that lesson in the third standard. We have learned that lesson in the third standard. In this year, like that way also we are going to see the same lesson here, but this is about a different person, another person. Okay student, so you should pay attention. So let's start the lesson. First is, look at here. Saturday, 15th August 1936, it was the day of the hockey finals during the Olympic events held in Berlin, Germany. Look at here students, what is given here? That is on the Saturday, 15th August 1936. It means that day. Keep in mind, 15th August 1936, it was the day of the hockey finals. Which games finals? Hockey finals during the Olympic events, Olympic Games. Do you know Olympic Games? Now the Olympic Games is going on. Which city? Do you know? In the city of Tokyo. During the days Olympic Games is going on the city, in the city Tokyo. And one player of the India's, he got medal, gold medal. Do you know students? If you know the name of that person, then write is in comment box. Okay students, so come back to our lesson. That is, on the day 15th August 1936, it was the day of the hockey's final during the Olympic events held in Berlin. It means on those day in the year 1936, Olympic events was going on in the Berlin at Germany. Okay students, so see the next, what is given that here? Look at here. Germany had defeated several teams to enter the final against the Indian team. There were the host of the Olympics, and they were sure of their victory. Look at here students, Germany defeated the several teams. Defeated manje haravine, to lost. Okay students, Germany had defeated the several teams, and they entered the final against the Indian team. It means two teams were there in a final. Which two teams? Germany's team and Indian team. Okay students, did you understand? In the Olympic Games, those Olympic Games held on 1936. Where it is? That was held in Berlin, Germany. Okay students, and in there There were only two teams for the hockey game in the final round. That was which two teams? Germany team and Indian team. Okay, students, did you understand? That is, they were the host of the Olympics and they were sure their victory. Look at here. They were the host of the Olympics and they were sure their victory. Perhaps that was the reason why their ruler Hitler and himself come to watch the match. Look at here, students. And it means in the 1936, there were ruler. One ruler was there and his name was Hitler. Okay, students. And he had himself come there to watch that match. Okay, students. So we will see the next. What is given there next? All the day before, it had rained heavily. The entire field had become waterlogged. Look at here, students. What happened at the day before? It means before the 15th August. On the 14th August, it had rained heavily. It means there where rain came, so much rain came there. And because that entire field, it means entire ground, whole ground had become waterlogged. Waterlogged, it means entirely water, full of water. So all ground became too much wet or too much watered. Okay, see the next. But in the 15th August being the last day of the games, it was not possible to postpone the match any further. The Indian team was a little under pressure as they had lost to Germany in the practice match and they were not very comfortable with the wet ground. Look at here, students. Here was a Indian team. On the 15th August, what happened? That was the last day of the games and it was not possible to postpone the game because there were all ground, it became wet. There were so much water on the ground because of before day, it means on the 14th August, there had a heavy rain there. Okay, students, that's why all ground became very wet. So the Indian team were not comfortable with a wet ground. Did you understand, students? So Indian teams became a little under pressure how to lose the Germany team. Okay, students, so pay attention. Look at here. About the 40,000 people had gathered in the hockey stadium. Look at here, students. What is given here? About the 40,000 people had gathered in the hockey stadium to cheer Germany against India. The Maharaja of Baroda State, the Prince of Bhopal and few other Indians had also come to support the Indian team. Look at here, students. That games, that Olympic events held in the Berlin, and there were 40,000 people had gathered on the hockey stadium to cheer the Germany against the India. And from India, there the Maharaja of Baroda State, the Prince of Bhopal and a few other Indians had also came to support the our Indian team. Did you understand, student? 40,000 people supported to the Germany team and our Indians also, few Indians went there to support our Indian team. So look at here. The match started exactly at 11 a.m. The German team had adopted a novel strategy of using the Indian technique of the short distance passes against the Indian team itself. Look at here, students. What is given here? That match is exactly started at 11 a.m. and the German team had adopted a novel strategy of using the Indian technique of the short distance passes against the Indian team itself. It means they used the Indian technique for this playing because they know that India lost them in their practice match. So they know the techniques about the Indian team. Look at here. The next we will see. They had resorted to very aggressive play. The Indian team was offering an equally strong resistance. No team could make a goal during the first half hour. During the 32nd minute, Roop Singh scored the first goal, hitting the ball towards the goal post from a difficult angle. Look at here, students. Here is one name came, that is Roop Singh from our Indian team. It means 11 player. In Indian team, there were 11 players for playing the game hockey. Okay, students. And when the match was going on between the Germany's players and Indians player, Germany team and Indian team. So, in the equal resistance, no one did the goal during the first half hour. It means that a small ball we have to keep in the goal. Okay, students, with the stick. So, do you know the game of hockey? If you don't know, so the first watch the game hockey, how to they played, then you will understand what is the here told that and what is that said here by the writer. No team could make a goal during the first half hour, and during the 32nd minutes that is left, the Roop Singh scored a first goal, hitting the ball towards the goal post from the difficult angle. Okay, students, so we will see the next. Look at here. In the second half of the match, the Indian team found a firm footing. The entire team played as one and made three more goals against Germany. Look at here. Then the second half of the match, Indian team played very best. Okay, students, and they did 1-2 after that, three more goals against the Germany's team. Two of them were made by the captain of the Indian team, Dhyan Chand. However, the Germany players were also trying their level best to win. They too succeed in making one goal. Look at here, student. Then what happened? Indian team, how many goals were made? Indian team were made three goals. Okay, students, how many goals? Three goals. And in between these three goals, two of them, who made? Captain Dhyan Chand, who was the captain of Indian team. Okay, students, it means Dhyan Chand made two goals from between the three goals. Okay, students, then next, look at it. Germany players were also trying their level best to win and then to succeed in making one goal, and they also tried very best and they made one goal. Now only a few last minutes were left. Dhyan Chand had resolved to win. Look at here. Now here only last few minutes were left, and Dhyan Chand has resolved to win. So see on the next page what is given here. On the next page you can see here, students. The match at any cost, without allowing Germany to make any more goals, his spiked shoe were making it difficult for him to run fast on the wet ground. Look at here, student. Here is a given the picture of Major Dhyan Chand. You can see here. It means last few minutes left and the ground was wet. Wet ground was there. So because of his shoes, he can't run fastly on the wet ground. So what he did, Mr. Dhyan Chand, look at here. He removed the shoes and the socks and began to run barefoot, using his amazing skill of dribbling and his near magical game. He began to send one pass after another to the players in the D, that is, in these defenders or the opponents'
area from where they could make a goal. So look at here, student. Then what he did? He did that. He removed his shoes and he removed his socks. And he runs very fastly with a barefoot. It means in Marathi we can say the mokle pay. त्यांनी त्यांचे शूज काढले, सॉक्स काढले आणि ते असेच मोकळ्या पायाने ग्राउंडवरती काय झाले, धावायला लागले विथ अ अमेझिंग स्किल. बिकॉज ऑफ वेट ग्राउंड अँड हिज शूज ही कांट रन प्रॉपरली. सो व्हॉट ही डीड, ही रिमूव्ह हिज सॉक्स अँड हिज शूज अँड ही रन विथ अ बेअर फूट. अँड इमिजिएटली व्हॉट ही डीड, ही पास ऑर सेंडेड हिज बॉल फ्रॉम वन टू अदर. ओके स्टुडंट्स, सो they did not let the passes go waste. The Indian team scored 3 more goals. Dhyan Chand could have easily made the goals himself from his own position, but he never played a selfish game. Skillfully, he took the balls away from the German defenders and made it possible for the players in the D to score goals. Look at here, he didn't, students, he didn't played the game selfishly. They passes to the ball, Germany team also, defenders also, and he taken the ball from there also, because he was very skillful person in the game hockey. So he played very much skillfully played the game hockey on the stadium of Berlin in the Olympic Games. So and he got a more 3 goal again. He scored again 3 goal, more goals. So he played very beautifully, very skillfully. Students, this is all for today. We have learned here about the Major Dhyan Chand, who was the captain of Indian team in the Olympic game which held in the Berlin on the 15th August 1936. So students, this is all for today. We will meet in the next video with a remaining topics. Till that time, stay healthy, stay happy and keep study. Thank you.